We are used to talking about exotic food when it comes to people, but do you know that animals also can have very specific eating habits too? And sometimes the things they eat shock those who have a queasy stomach or a weak nervous system. So be ready to be surprised. I'm gonna show you the most unusual animal food ever. Orangutans generally eat leaves and fruits, which they carefully pick among the treetops. But when they come down from the trees and travel across the jungle floor, they sometimes eat clay-containing soil. Why? Scientists collected the soils chosen by the orangutans and examined it. They found out that the soils contained quite a lot of iron. Orangutans may prefer eating soils for the same reason that people take pills to alleviate diarrhea. Leaf-eating apes are at a constant risk of diarrhea. Clay minerals can help to neutralize toxins in the digestive system. Researchers think that early people used the clayed soil for the same reason. Eating soil is strange, of course, but some creatures adopted a more extreme diet. Mason bees, for example, eat toxic plants that, in fact, offer little nutrition. These bees differ greatly from the bees familiar to us. They are black, splashed with blues and greens. Besides, they live a solitary life without a hive, don't make honey, and feed their larvae with pollen. A few species of mason bees only collect pollen from daisies and sunflowers. These plants are low in protein and a bit toxic. Bee larvae grow more slowly on this diet, but why do they act like that? The thing is, the bees need this pollen to protect their young from parasitic sapyaga wasps. Mason bees built their houses in the holes, constructing walls from mud. Before the mud walls dry, the wasps lay their eggs into the mason bees' nest cells. When the wasp larvae appear, they eat everything, including the mason bee's egg. But when the house is covered with pollen from daisies and sunflowers, wasp larvae die. Besides, the bee covers its house with it, and wasps try to avoid such a place. Not long ago, scientists revealed that one species of a moth drinks tears from the eyes of sleeping birds. An adult moth lives only to mate. It stored up nutrients during the larval stage and almost doesn't need food, but it needs liquid to drink. The insects use a very strange proboscis shaped like a harpoon to get it. This can be inserted under the bird's eyelids, where the barbs anchor it, apparently without disturbing the bird. The specialists do not yet know if the insects spit out an anesthetic to reduce the irritation. Isolation on a deserted island can lead to some pretty desperate behavior and an exotic diet. Sharp-beaked ground finches live on the Galapagos Islands. On the four of them, the birds have an unusual diet of insects. But the finches, that live on the two rocky islands of Darwin and Wolf, have turned into a fearsome subspecies called the vampire finches. The reason is that these birds have developed a nasty habit. They use their sharp beaks to peck through the skin of blue-footed booby birds and drink their blood. A finch lands on the tail of a booby. Then it pecks at the base of the booby's wing feathers with its beak until the skin breaks and the blood begins to flow. It sips the blood for a few seconds, while other finches wait patiently to partake of this bloody party. Arctic skuas, also called parasitic jaggers, live most of their lives at sea and come ashore only to breed in the Arctic summer. And these birds spend their time stealing much of their food from other birds. But the way the skuas do this is too extravagant. Skuas are extremely aggressive. They attack seagulls and terrorize their victims very intensely, until they're so exhausted and terrified that they have to puke. This is what the squaws want. The squaw comes closer and steals a nice, curdled mass of stinking, partially digested seafood. Squaw have been observed attacking alone, as well as creating teams of hunters to take away birds' meals. Caecilians look like giant earthworms, but are actually not. They are legless amphibians that live primarily underground and can be found in Central and South America, as well as Southeast Asia. These creatures usually eat worms, termites, and other insects, but not all of them. There is one species of caecilians in Africa that has another exotic eating habit. Being young, caecilians peel off their mother's skin and eat it. They are equipped with a specialized dentition, which they use to peel the skin. This strange food provides the young with some necessary nutrients and fat. Mom's skin grows back every 3 days. This process goes on until the babies are grown. Zombie worms don't want to eat brains, they're interested in bones instead. These things are 1 to 3 inches and are officially called Ossidax worms. They were first discovered in 2002. Scientists found them living in the bones of a rotting gray whale on the seafloor, nearly 10,000 feet deep. Zombie worms don't eat mineral bones, but they digest fats within the bone. But the secret is that they have no mouth or stomach. They secrete an acid from their skin that erodes bones, freeing up the fat and protein hidden inside. Besides, there are symbiotic bacteria living inside the worm that digest the fat and protein. How do worms get nutrients from bacteria? Scientists don't know yet. In Brazil, yellow chevron parakeets build their nests in abandoned termite mounds. Birds expand the tight cavities in mounds to make space for their families. But sometimes parakeets start eating bits of the mound walls. Scientists examined the material that mounds are made of and found out that the soil from termite mounds contains several times more organic matter than the ground soil. It also has more macronutrients, such as phosphorus and potassium. The researchers think these nutrients are particularly useful when producing eggs and bringing up young. Besides, termite mound soil could also neutralize plant toxins and cause a lot of problems for the fruit-eating parakeets. You know that hares eat grass and shrubs, but sometimes they prefer something warmer and softer. Japanese hares decided that eating their own poop is not a bad thing. They like it so much that they gulp it down without chewing. Researchers think that these hares found the way to extract as many nutrients from their food as possible. Small plant-eating animals like hares burn more energy than large herbivores do, and they need to take in more energy from their food. The poo is a very effective decision. The Japanese hares do this so selectively, eating on the most nutritious bits of poop. Strange, but a working living strategy. The demonic species of ants were discovered in 1994 by the scientists working in Madagascar. The researchers gave these looking-like wasp creatures the specific name Adetomyrma, but they also have another name, which is Dracula ants. As apart from their unusual look, the ants have a habit to drink blood of their young. As ants can't digest solid food, they give their solid food to their larvae. Their larvae digest the food and regurgitate it as honeydew. This liquid is what the adults eat. Dracula ants chew a hole into their larvae and suck out the ant equivalent of blood. This does not kill the larva, but researchers observed the young acting in fear when it came time to feed. That's all for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. Which food did you find to be the most unusual one? Let me know in the comments.